Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome to episode 2 on Bedrock Wonderland. And as you can see behind me, we have the ocean monument we beat in the first episode, and today we're going to try and take it down. And in order to do that, we're going to need a ton of sand, so I'm just cruising past Cat's base here on our way to the desert. It's looking good. It's about the fifth time we've been to the desert now. This is such a chore. It's taken me a good 2 days of non-stop playing just to smelt up all this glass and place it. It'll all be worth it in the end though. When I've got this thing up and running, it should be a pretty good farm for XP and materials. While I'm mucking about with this monument, I want to take a minute to show you guys some of the stuff going on over at Spawn. This is Spawn. This is our Mushroom Island. It's an amazing seed, to be honest. It's got this Mushroom Island in the middle, a real small amount of ocean, and then pretty much every biome you can imagine. This platform here is where you spawn in. It's where we put our single sleep system. And yeah, hopefully we'll see a few shops all start to spread out around here and start looking good. Yeah, talking about shops, it looks as though Simon has finished his sugarcane shop. It's the first shop in Bedrock Wonderland. And it's looking pretty good. Got some mushrooms in there. Sugar, sweet. Good price. Sugar cane. Oh, paper. I think I might be his first customer because I plan on getting some villagers pretty soon. Brilliant. Great shot. Nice one, Simon. Hey, look who it is. Clark is over. He's after some sea lanterns. So I told him to come and help himself because obviously the farm isn't finished yet and I don't have a prismarine shop just yet. He's got his new skin on as well. It's looking great. Oh, it looks even better with that chainmail stuff on. Sweet. Yeah, man. See that, man. It's all yours. Help yourself. It's that time of the season once again when I've got to try and capture a couple of these pain in the butts and move them back to my temporary base. And that was great fun, as you could imagine. Now I've got the even more fun task of trying to get the trades that I actually want. And I reckon this could take a while. Here we go, 45 minutes later, and we have a fairly cheap mending trade. That really sucks, but I had nothing else to do while all this glass was smelting, so anyway, it doesn't matter, we got him in the end. Sweet. Finally, we're at the point now where we can start getting rid of some of this water. Even more fun. Cat's popped over, drying out my sponges for me. She's given me a load of coal, to trade for a load of bones that I'm getting for all these fish I'm killing. So this is my life for probably the next 12 hours. Just breaking down sand, drying out sponges, taking out water, then breaking the sand down, drying out the sponges, taking out the water over and over and over, which it should all be worth it, but I am not taking a ocean monument again. It is the biggest labor in Minecraft by far. And at last, all the water is gone, and that temple is beautiful. I think we should destroy it. Check this out. So we got two sponge rooms in the first episode where we actually beat this place, and I've just found two more. I've heard of two sponge rooms being rare, but four, Jesus. Now we start the process of ripping this place out, which means using more sponges again. It's all gone. It is all gone. It's not over yet though. I'm gonna take the floor out and go all the way down to the seabed. But I just wanted to stop quick, show you my progress, and show you just how much stuff I got from wiping this place out. I should be able to sell this before I've even built the Guardian Farm. It's a good bit of stock. This place gets better and better. I mean, four sponge rooms, super rare. And I've got a slime chunk right spot bang in the middle of it. Now, most people would probably just find another chunk to build a slime farm, but because I've wiped out the entire space down here, I'm actually gonna do a double. I'm gonna build a Guardian Farm and a slime farm all within my base, because I'm special. I've got five stacks of slime balls sort of in the last 20 minutes that I've been taking the water out of this little area, so I think a slime shop is on the horizon, as well as a prismarine shop. Awesome. There we go, we're at the seafloor. It's all gone, everything's fresh and ready to be built on. And with that, I'm going to call this an episode. I think we've done pretty well over the last few days. As always, thanks for watching, guys. Like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you over in episode 3. And hopefully we'll be doing something quite a bit different, because I can't finish this place, because the Nether update isn't here yet. Anyway, peace.